To get into the Elementor Builder, you go over here to Pages, and then you hover over any page and you click on Edit with Elementor. There is also another way. Go to your page on the front end of your website and click over here on Edit with Elementor. Both methods work the same, but this saves you some searching in the back end of your WordPress pages. Elementor works with widgets or elements that are placed inside of containers. To add a new element to your page, click on this plus icon over here on the left side, and then add in a container or a grid, whatever you want, to the place you want to do it. Click on this plus icon again and drag anything you want to this container. Just a heading, for example, or maybe an image. You can drag and drop everything from the left side over here on elements. If you get Elementor Pro, you have a lot more elements to choose from. And to be honest, if you're building a professional website, you definitely need Elementor Pro. Each container gives you complete flexibility to change the layout of the elements in the container. So we can select the container over here. For example, the direction. You can change how the direction should behave inside of this container, but also justify the content. Let's give it some more minimum height. There we are. And we can justify all the content now, for example, in the center, at the end, with space in between, space around, or space evenly. This also works for the alignment of your items. Place them in the center, at the end, or just stretch them to the full width if you have a big image, for example. If you go to style over here, you can add in a background overlay, and you can also use the shape dividers. Now this also works with elements. If you click on any element on your website, on the left side, you can change the content, the styling, and also advanced options like, for example, transform it or motion effects. Now this works with any element and any container and gives you extreme flexibility. To quickly see what you want to change in your page, go over here and open the Structure tab. Now you can easily click on each element to find it and to change it. You can also rename these sections and elements. Just double click it and change the name so you can easily recognize it later on. Or you can also let AI do it by clicking on this button, Rename Containers with AI. This is very useful if you have long pages and you quickly want to find something. Talking about finding things, if you go over here and open up the Finder, you can type anything you want to find in Elementor, also different pages. You just type in the name of the page and you can find your header, your contact page, or any mention with these specific words inside of your entire website. Very useful to quickly go to the About Us page. If you want to make changes to the mobile version only, click over here to change the display. All the changes that you then make will be created, look at this, in the mobile portrait version. This is called responsive design and works perfectly within Elementor. Duplicating or copying sections, elements, containers, and everything inside of it is really, really easy. Just right-click on the element you want to duplicate and press it over there, or press copy and paste it anywhere else. You can also just paste the styling of the widget, for example, which is very useful in a lot of situations. By the way, if you enjoy this video, please hit that like button and subscribe to my channel, because these statistics are just making me a little bit anxious. Thank you very much, I really appreciate it. Let's get back to the video. When designing your website, the chances are that you want to have the same header and the same footer on each and every page. You can easily create global parts by going to the Theme Builder. To go there, you click over here and press on Theme Builder. Here you can add in all these parts by just clicking this plus icon on it. Or if you already created one, click on it, and then you can press on Edit over here. When you have created your perfect header or footer or any global part of your website, click over here and click on Display Conditions. Here we can change all the permissions to include or exclude this part on whatever page or post you want. So for your Instagram landing page sales funnel, you will have a different kind of header than the rest of your website. If you have Elementor Pro, you can also create pop-ups. Go to Templates and go to here, Pop-ups. These are very useful and no need to buy another plugin to have this feature. To make your entire website consistent, you should make use of the powerful global colors and fonts. By using these, you can at any given time change all the colors and all the fonts of your entire website from there. No need to change every single element on your website one by one. You go over here to the settings, and then we click on here global colors. This also means when you add new elements, you can change the font and colors to any global part. This will save you a huge amount of time, and it's also just best practice to start creating your website with your global colors and your global fonts. If you don't feel like designing yourself, you can easily import blocks and entire pages that are pre-built. To do that, click over here. Here you can find all the blocks, and here you can see a lot of different kinds of pages. There are also a lot of templates available to buy on the internet, which you can just import in your website. If you want to learn how to create an entire e-commerce website with Elementor, click over here and I'll guide you through all the steps from A to Z. If you want to learn the basics of WordPress itself, click over this other video over there. And if you have any questions, just put them down in the comments. I'll always reply. Thank you so much for watching. I hope to see you in the next video.